shout and deny until people believe what you're saying. And you talk about his believers listen to him. You worked in the White House for Ronald Reagan. What would the consequence be for putting out a statement with any sort of factual error?
Oh, it would be a firing offense. Absolutely. I mean, it astonishes me. I'll see statements come out of the White House, press statements that have ridiculous misspellings and typographical errors. I mean, there was a large staff of people in the White House whose only job was proofreading and editing and fact-checking. I don't think they employ any of those people any longer, or if they do, they're completely incompetent. And there are apparently no consequences for doing things that embarrass the president because he does the same things to himself, and he's not embarrassed by them. So I'm, you know, gobsmacked.
Yeah. So how do you explain, though, these two different worlds that you describe in terms of what was and what is now?
Well, I think there's been a great sorting in our political system. The party of Trump has become the party of stupidity and ignorance and corruption. And the people who are in the bubble don't know they're in the bubble any more than a goldfish knows that it's in a bowl. They get all of their information from approved right-wing Republican sources, and they explain everything away, just the way you did in your report, where they just, you know, one day we didn't do it, the next day we did it, but it was okay, and the next day it was a brilliant strategy, you know, that everybody should have been following. It's just constant deception that is so regular that people can't keep track of it, you know? The Washington Post list of Trump's lies is up over, I think, 13,000.
Yeah.
So
as we move to this next phase of the impeachment inquiry, and we hear public testimony from these witnesses, I mean, you see those three on your screen right now, Bill Taylor, George Kent, and Marie Yovanovitch, who are among those who will testify this coming week. Do you think these public hearings will move the needle or change people's perspectives?
Well, I hope so, but I'm not optimistic because what are they going to say that we don't already know, really? And none of these things, none of these facts that have come out already have had any impact. I think the Republicans will just disseminate, lie, and make up things. And unfortunately, their brain-dead followers will go along with it.
Well, I have faith in the American people, and hopefully the truth will prevail. Bruce Bartlett, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Another billionaire is toying with